Sterling Properties of Santa Barbara proudly presents Ken Boxer Live. From the American Riviera in Santa Barbara, California, it's Ken Boxer Live with your host, Ken Boxer, and co-host, two-time Olympian Tai Babilonia. Please welcome Ken and Tai.
What a great audience. This is, thank you so much. Thank you, and thank you for joining us. I'm Ken Boxer. Let me introduce you to my very talented co-host, two-time Olympian. Not just that, she's also the five-time national champion, as well as an Olympian. We have Tai Babilonia.
Thank you, Ken. Thank you. Yes. I love this audience.
Oh, it's a great audience. Yeah. Tell our audience, let's start from the beginning. Just tell the audience who we have on this show.
This is so bizarre and so surreal for me. Never in a million years did I would think I would be interviewing my best friend, my skating partner of over four decades.
Unbelievable.
Four decades. Unbelievable. And it's now happening. I've been posting on Facebook a lot of blurbs and old photos, and I'm so happy that Randy said yes, and I just gave it away. My partner, Randy Gardner, is going to be on the show tonight. I'm so excited.
But, you know, I got to tell you, one of the most difficult type of interviews would be an interview in which you're having to interview somebody you know very well.
Exactly.
It's going to be difficult, I imagine.
It will be emotional. I mean, I was emotional on the drive here, just thinking about what I I'll see a photo and I'll get weepy. So it should be interesting. It could go in a gazillion different directions.
All right, well, let's go to the direction of let's get busy.
Yes, so don't go away. We'll be right back with my partner, two-time Olympian, Randy Gardner.
All right.
Ken Boxer Live, brought to you in part by the Wildcat Lounge, repeatedly voted Santa Barbara's best dance club. The Eagle Inn, a family-owned hotel near the beach in Santa Barbara. And by Santa Barbara Chicken Ranch, authentic Mexican-style mesquite barbecue. Now back to Ken Boxer Live.
Thank you. And we are back. Ever since Tai Babilonia joined our show, she's always been saying to me that we must get Randy Gardner on our show. Well, tonight it's finally happening. Tonight, Randy Gardner is with us, a true sports legend and one of the world's best ice skating champions. And in honor of this special occasion, having Randy and Tai together, we'll be producing two episodes with Randy as our only guest, a part one and a part two. In part one, we'll be discussing Randy's early years up through the 1980 Olympic Games. In part two, we'll be discussing from those Olympic Games to the present day. Now, considering all the events Tai and Randy have shared throughout their professional lives, from their preteen years to their adolescence and later young adulthood, these interviews will have a bottomless well of possible directions. And we'll plan to take you there, so sit back and let's welcome the ice skating legend and five-time national champion, world champion, Randy Gardner. Welcome.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh, goodness, thank you.
We did it.
It's so nice to have you here.
Oh, thank you. It's great to be here. I like the bobblehead.
Oh, it's one of a kind. Do you have one? Your own
of
bobblehead?
You?
This is you.
I do not.
Everyone says it looks like President Bush, but
it's supposed to be similar.
And then I don't have one.
But have you been, to Santa Barbara? This is your first time?
I love Santa Barbara. I've been up here on vacation throughout the years and stuff, and I haven't been here in a while. Driven through lately, but it's such a wonderful place, and you have such a great show, and the hotel's great. And
isn't it lovely?
I'd love
you
to
got
work
a great
here.
Room.
What a great room.
The city of Santa Barbara's welcoming you with open arms. Yes,
thank
right?
Thank you.
To be here. Thank you. So let's start at, early Randy Gardner.
You Take
haven't
the
met
journey.
Him yet. You haven't met him at this
oh,
point.
Okay. Okay. Oh, okay. Oh, pre-me.
Pre-skates.
Okay, got it. Pre-me. Pre-tie.
Okay.
Got
what,
it.
What was going on before skates? Were you active in sports?
I started skating when I was about, I was like seven, and actually I just realized the other day, next year is my 50 years in figure skating.
Wow.
That's
congratulations.
So, yeah. So,
that's huge.
Yeah, so I'm doing things on my bucket list I want to accomplish and check off the list or revisit. You know, so that's exciting. So before I started skating, I was dancing. I was a dancer, and you know, in the local.
Wait, before seven?
Yeah, I was dancing. Yeah, tap dancing, tap, okay. Jazz, ballet, all that stuff, and then.
Wait a minute! I saw a picture of you with a baseball bat.
I did.
Did you try
farm league, farm team? But that was kind of.
Was that before the dancing?
It was like Pee Wee League or something.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Along the same time as I started skating was that.
Okay.
Yeah,
with the baseball. I remember that photo.
Yeah, I was doing all that stuff, and then I started skating because I always liked to watch it on TV. You know, it was a great thing to watch. And then neighborhood friends went, and then I, you know, joined them on Saturday public sessions. And started that way, but and I kept dancing kind of simultaneous with the skating, but then the skating took over.
And why did it take over? What happened?
Well, because it kind of had to, you know. It's a sport that you have to sort of be dedicated to.
But at 7 years of age?
Well, then seven, eight, nine, you know, around there, and it's really the only thing I wanted to do after that. Really?
Was that like with you, Ty? Same? When you?
I was hooked. I was obsessed with it, and it was I saw Peggy Fleming on television. She was doing all these beautiful specials and competing, and just, it was, and I didn't know what skating was, really. I didn't know what it entailed. I didn't know that it was going to be cold in an ice rink and that you're going to fall, but once I got into it, you couldn't get me out of the rink. Well, and I think Randy might have been the same way. The rink where we skated was in Culver City, and it was the perfect babysitter. You know, our parents could just drop us off and we'd be with our coach and we would be safe.
How long did you skate before you actually met Ty?
Had to have been a couple of years, at least two. And I love skating and I was kind of good at it, but I was last in my first competition and I struggled because I was little. And I wasn't as strong as the other boys were. And so then I had to sort of mature into that, you know. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then met Tai. She was skating. We had the same coach, Mabel Fairbanks, and then Mabel put us together for the club show at the rink in Culver City.
Tell the whole story. Tell the details of this.
The details in just a second because we're going to go to a clip. And we'll see you performing as young children.
Okay.
And in this clip, do you remember what this clip was that we're about to see?
This is a little bit later. We had, if this is a clip from 1973, we had since changed coaches. And this clip in 73 is really when it's like the train has left the station and it was full tilt from then on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's watch Randy and Tai.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Excellent. If you're just joining us, our guest this half hour is Randy Gardner and, of course, our co-host Tai Babilonia, both together. Yes. When we're watching this video, do you both have any input into the choreography, or is somebody else doing that 100%?
Not so much at that age. Later, as we got older, we were more vocal about that. But then it was pretty much the coach, and he had to be guided. And, you know, I think at that point, it was John Nixon. He had to shape us. And so, you know, but I think kids need that, you know.
But there's a Jewish expression called cavelling. I'm watching Tai looking at you, cavelling. Just like, it's so nice to have you here.
Oh.
You know.
Well, it's so true. It's flashback time. But before this, I was telling Randy, there's more to the story of how we got together. And it wasn't, you know, it wasn't hunky-dory and it wasn't smooth sailing. We had to be bribed to hold hands by Mabel Fairbanks, the woman who put us together. And I would not hold his hand because he had this disease called cooties, this little kid disease, and he also had blisters on his hands. Yeah. So she literally had to bribe me with Barbie dolls and candy just to skate around the ring together. But once we got the hang of it and, you know, got to know each other better, I really didn't know him that well. But, I was 8 years old.
But what was Randy's take on it when you first met Tai?
She was a shy little girl playing with dolls, and she had the most beautiful golden hair, you know, and shy. And you bring all your dolls to the rink.
I would bring my Barbie.
Barbies.
Doll. Yes, I was Barbie fanatic.
Yeah.
And I would set them up. They had a little snack shop there, and I would set the dolls up, and Randy would come and you know, do whatever he had to do with the dolls just to tease me.
Right.
You know, it was just teasing.
I was trying to get her attention.
Kids. And Randy was, you know, Randy was a much better skater, I think, than I was.
Well, I started sooner.
And you had gold blades, which is very.
Did you
so chic?
Did you think the same, that you were a better skater?
Well, I didn't really think that. But I knew I had been around longer, at the age of 9.
Okay. Season.
But you know, let's kind of jump a little bit into the future. You're now preparing for world championships.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, you took a big jump.
Yeah, big jump.
You took a leap.
I took a leap.
Okay.
What kind of twirl is that called in skating? That type of leap.
A very fast spin.
Yeah. Okay. Or a falling leaf. Well, here's my question to you, Randy, because we both did singles and pairs, and in 19, and Randy excelled as a solo skater better than I did. He was a novice. Silver medalist, national.
I was going to national championships in singles as well.
And he was a junior national champion as a solo. And at some point, 1977, I was doing singles too, but just not at the level he was. We kind of had to choose between singles and pairs. Yeah. So what was that, because you were good and you were a great senior man. Was it hard making that decision?
So, well,
we were excelling in pairs.
Yeah, but remember those days it was really hard, the training, the school figures.
Yes.
Short program of both and all that stuff.
Well, scheduling.
And scheduling. Sure. And I was getting older. I was getting tired. It was tiring, even though I was probably, 15, 16, maybe around there. But it was hard, you know, so the training schedule was getting tough. Also, were we U.S. champions then? When we decided to not do singles
anymore. Yes, in 1977.
So we were U.S. pair champions, so U.S. figure skating, the governing body of figure skating in the country, they really they wanted to prime us and get us in there because it was our chance, and we were excelling at the world. We had gone to the Olympics already. Mm-hmm. And so we were kind of their hope in pair skating. So they were doing everything they could to keep us going. Mm-hmm. So they were making sure that we were training correctly and all that stuff.
Okay, well, obviously it worked out because you won in 1979. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1979 world champion. Let's see a clip of the routine, because we have a clip of this routine.
Oh,
let's go.
Nice.
Let's go right now.
Since pair competition started in 1908, only one American pair has ever won this championship. This, then, is a very big moment for American figure skating.
And the first of their program, the first five or six moves, are the power moves and the difficult ones. They open first with a throw triple salchow. Here it is. Hey. Beauty, lovely, very nice.
a good start. They're next, a split double twist. Here it is. That was nice. The difference with the looseness with which she landed compared to some of the Russians in the earlier movements are the difference in maturity. A swan lift. Lovely position. Look at the extension. The arc of that. Very, very fun. One arm, swan lift into a star lift. And a throw, double axel. Here it is. Watch him lift her. Nice, nice, nice. What they are doing is skating with control. They know that they are the champion so far, and they're showing it every inch of the way. Steady, secure, and complete.
This could be a little sporting history. The end of their program.
Here it is, a death spiral. He has only not to go off the edge, or she too. And there it is. It is it.
Tai Babilonia and Randy Gardner. Again, the pair's championship started in 1908. Only one American pair has ever won the world championship. The Kennedys in 1950. And now supported by a big crowd of Americans here. Tai and Randy may have done it. They sure look like they think they've done it. Remember, their lead was very, very small, however, over the Russians. Isn't that a great scene? Isn't that beautiful?
Absolutely beautiful. Randy Gardner is our guest on our show. Randy, when you see that, does it just seem like a blur? Or is it something that you still vividly recollect daily?
I remember doing it. I remember that felt like, and I remember that my skate came untied the last 30
that's
seconds.
Right. Oh, really? Uh-huh.
And I remember being out there, of course, but I remember more the build up to that whole sort of that season. And when Dick Button says it was a close after the short program he met, it was like, we were like tense. Away in the, did we win the short program?
Yes, we did.
Yeah, but we were close.
But yeah, it was.
And we had these East Germans and these Russians behind us, and it was like those days where you had to fight your you know what off to get there. So we, so I remember the push, that drive.
And I remember the training.
And the training.
Beforehand.
Well, tell our audience, how long did it take in terms of, not a lifetime, but to do that routine? That choreography, how long did it take to get into perfection?
That was 1979, and we had a couple good seasons before that. Right. We won nationals and worked our way up the ladder at the world championships and all that. I guess we got that probably in spring or summer before the March world championships, which is when that was.
Right.
You sort of change it out as you go. You do a couple trial competitions in the fall, and then you sort of, you know, change costumes and you get it going and your skating changes and develops those last couple of months.
We were doing double run-throughs.
Ouch.
Remember that? We were doing double run-throughs. Yeah. We would go and take our skates off, go run around the parking lot. This was all for endurance. And then come back into the rink. So we were so well trained for that competition.
Now, how much input did you have into that routine? Or was it, again, somebody providing the choreography?
I think the coach kind of oversaw everything pretty much, you know.
What were you feeling on the bow? Yes, after this, on the final bow. Was it relief? Was it, because I know what I was feeling at the time.
It was joy, relief. It was, you know, just exuberance.
Yeah.
Well, let's go to the clip. I want to hear and get your
response.
Let's watch both of you on the victory stand.
Okay.
In 1979. Okay. Let's watch.
Come a long, long way since we saw them 5 years ago. Now the second set coming up. Look at that. 5-9, 5-9, 5-9, 5-8, 5-9, 6.0. A perfect mark from the West German. 5-7, 5-7, and even the Canadian judge gives them a 5-7. They've got it, there's no question. You're looking at only the second American pair ever to win the world championship in pairs figure skating. And
There it is, the award of the flowers to the new world champions, Tai Babilonia and Randy Gardner of the United States. Only the second American since these championships started in 1908, first American pair to win since the Kennedys in 1950, 29 years ago. They're standing by now for that moment that they've been awaiting, the playing of the American National Anthem. A scene of pure joy. Look at them, Tai and Randy. Could it be a forecast of the Olympic Games in Lake Placid, New York? Less than a year from now, well, their job will be even tougher then. But now they're the world champions, and somebody's going to have to take that reputation away from them.
Randy Gardner, ladies and gentlemen. Randy, Tai.
I want Randy to tell everyone where those costumes are, those royal blue costumes.
They're in the Smithsonian.
Oh, yes, they wow. are.
In the Museum of American History.
Right.
Yeah. And so it was really kind of cool because we were on tour with Ice Capades and they had sent the word out that they wanted to put those in. And so we went, there was a ceremony or that meeting.
Right,
thing,
I have a photo.
And we gave them, we had to give them up because once the Smithsonian takes them, that's it.
So they're still there.
They're not
displayed, but they're you know, safely in a drawer somewhere. But they're there. We don't have them.
Well, so they were up. They were displayed. We went to go see them. Oh, my God. They were by the Supremes.
Oh, really?
No.
Yeah, they were. And Henry Winkler's.
Supremes. Henry Winkler. They
the
were
Fonzie's
by Charlie
jacket.
McCarthy. They were by all these things that, you know, it was amazing. You know, I was like, oh, my God. Wow. Yeah. It was awesome.
Well, let's talk also about the 1980 Olympic Games, mm-hmm. which were, in a lot of respect, looking back, very difficult for you two. And you were our sweethearts. We wanted you to win.
Right.
Tell our viewing audience, some of them may not know what happened.
Well, we'd come out of that.
Right.
Yes.
That was right before, you know, the year. So that was the beginning of the ramp up.
Yeah.
And so Olympics were in Lake Placid in the U.S., first time in a long time. And
you're expected to win,
mm-hmm.
being that you've just had this mm-hmm. championship.
Right.
And so, you know, the it was that ramp up. Renina Zaitsev, who weren't in that year because she was out having a baby, were back. And so we were going to go head on with them. And she was two-time Olympic champion at that point already. So, yeah, I think we could have done it. But I got.
Cigarette, please.
I got injured. I pulled a groin muscle in training before I went to the Olympics, about 10 days before, on a jump, a double flip jump. And it was like, you know, I had injuries. We've all had injuries during our careers. And it was skatable and fine and not fine, but it was getting better. It was going to be okay. Got in the plane, did all that, went to Lake Placid, did opening ceremonies, were training. Went to a practice that night after opening ceremonies, and I re-injured it, and it was worse. It was left groin pull, but it went up into my stomach, and so I was hemorrhaging and stuff internally and all that. And it was just 2 days before the short program.
A lot of this I didn't know, and my question, and in fact I asked Mr. Nix this,
our coach,
Mr. Nix, decades later, maybe 2 years ago. I went to visit him, and I said, "Mr. Nix, if you know, with that whole the whole scene in Lake Placid, what would you, if we were to do it all over again, what would you have changed?" And he said, he would have asked the doctor. Dr. Daly was Randy's doctor at the time, who gave him the shot of xylocaine. Mm-hmm. Mr. Nix said, "I would have wanted to know exactly how much xylocaine was going into the injury, and you know what would be the repercussions?"
Sure.
And what happened was, Randy, he got the shot, and it did deaden the pain of the injury. But as we don't have a clip, you'll see his leg buckles underneath him.
Mm-hmm.
So,
during
obviously,
warm-ups,
the doctor, yes, mm-hmm. the doctor gave him too much because it deadened the whole rest of his leg. So it's, you know, it was a wild night, and I didn't know the pain that he was in.
We just have under a minute for this first show. But I just, was it?
I know.
Could it? Was the injury avoidable with hindsight?
No, because athletes get injured.
Preventive?
It played out. No, it played out. That I think the only way it could have, because right. I was like a racehorse. They were giving me everything they could to get Olympic Committee get him out there, and that's
okay. Well, we have much more to discuss. Okay, we knew this couldn't just be for
quickly
30 minutes. So. Randy, you're going to stay with us. We're going to continue the conversation.
Wait.
Thank you. Let me give you a nice handshake here.
Oh,
all right.
Thank you so
okay. It's so
good.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you. All right. Well, that's it for part one with our special guest, Randy Gardner. Now, stay tuned for part two, our next show, as we'll continue our conversation with the ice skating legend, Randy Gardner, on a special two-part episode of Ken Boxer Live. So for our guest, Randy Gardner, and for Tai Babilonia, and our director, George Montalvo, and the entire KBL crew, I'm Ken Boxer. Good night, everybody.
Ken Boxer Live is brought to you by the following sponsors. Sterling Properties of Santa Barbara, hometown feel, world-class service. Key Sabella, Santa Barbara's most comprehensive day spa with award-winning service. Palazzo Restaurant, where people don't leave hungry or thirsty. The Wildcat Lounge, repeatedly voted Santa Barbara's best dance club. Harbor View Inn, welcome to Santa Barbara's premier four-diamond luxury boutique oceanfront hotel. Wendy Foster, Santa Barbara and Montecito's premier clothing store. The Eagle Inn, a family-owned hotel near the beach in Santa Barbara. Via Rosa Inn, let us pamper you in international style. Hotel Milo, a classic Santa Barbara hotel on the beach. And by Taffy's Pizza, delivery, pickup, or dine in. Woody's Bodacious Barbecue, voted best barbecue in Santa Barbara for over 30 years. Santa Barbara Chicken Ranch, authentic Mexican style, mesquite barbecue. Los Arroyos Mexican Restaurant, takeout. Santa Barbara Bar, finally, nutritious tastes great. Sammy's Camera, new location at 530 State Street. Jack's Bagels and Bistro, serving the very best food in a friendly and relaxed atmosphere. Summer Lee, makeup artist, stylist, and aesthetician. Perfect Computers, since 1990. The Ken Boxer Live musical theme, composed and arranged by Mr. Michael J. Leslie. From all of us at Ken Boxer Live, I'm Baron Ron Heron. Good night, everyone.